morning, everyone. So we will start with the new programmatic advertising demo series for programmatic guaranteed deals, which are known as PG deals and preferred deals and PMP, private marketplace auction deals. So that will be decided, discussed and decided in the this series of programmatic advertising, and I will show you how these features work under Google Ad Manager dashboard, and how programmatic guaranteed deals, preferred deals, and PMP auction deals are carried out via the options available in Google Ad Manager. So we need to go in the second section after home, in the sales section, where the programmatic guaranteed deals, preferred deals, and PMP deals are available. So in the sales section, we click on the sales section, then we click on the proposal section. So here, as you can see, there are multiple proposals available where the review has been requested from the seller side, like from a publisher side, the review has been requested, and the deal has not been finalized yet. So if you want to see how this programmatic guaranteed deals look like, you can see. So this is how a programmatic guaranteed deals look like. It is a proposal for by like the ID is mentioned, the marketplace is mentioned, then the buyer is mentioned, and DB ID is mentioned, and the budget is mentioned, type of programmatic guaranteed mentioned, inventory type is mentioned, CPM is mentioned. So all these things are mentioned for the negotiation purpose. So once all these things are finalized, then the total number of impressions and audience list can also be decided. But the buyer as well as the seller has to agree on the terms and conditions mentioned in the deal which has been sent to the publisher. So the CPM has to be agreed on, and additionally the targeting, like display, desktop, mobile, or if there is any audience list of any age group, geo targeting, class based targeting, gender based targeting, that should be also done. If it is available, then you have buyer contact names. If you want to directly contact the buyers, then you can directly mail them and ask regarding the quote which has been received. So this is how this a request for proposal looks like, that is RFP. So RFP is a buyer initiated, and include campaign details desired by a buyer, and proposal line items can be added. So we'll go to proposal line item again. Go to the proposals. You see, if you want to create a new proposal, you want to send some proposal to the interested buyers, then you can click on new proposal. You can select advertiser, any advertiser if it is available. Select any advertiser which is suppose Amazon is the advertiser. Select buyer, you can select any. If you want, there are two options available. All in some buyers can only negotiate preferred deals, which is not guaranteed, but it will run when the inventory is free. It will run, and this is the programmatic guarantee that will it will run in a guaranteed manner, and the inventory needs to be reserved for this programmatic guaranteed deals. That is the basic difference between preferred deal and programmatic deal. That preferred deals are run when the inventories are available and there are no ads coming, and programmatic guaranteed deals are reserved deals, almost like a roadblock ad inventory or roadblock campaign, where the ad slots are blocked for that particular impression and particular day. So here you can select test account, and you can select one person, me as a seller. Then you can say also select salesperson. You can select trafficker. Sales planner is an optional thing. If you want to know sales planner, sales planners are who need to work on this proposal and can multiple ads. Sales planners, traffickers are the primary trafficker, who can do primary trafficking of this campaign. Primary salesperson, seller who is selling this proposal. Labels is optional, that you want to exclude ads, ad exclusion, competitive exclusion, or competitive ad exchange exclusion, that is optional. And customized fields are also optional. Like customized fields are like custom fields is do not carry over to the order when this proposal is sold and do not affect ad serving. They belong only to this one and are for information purpose only. You want to, if the ad is being run through any ad agency, you can write any ad agency name over here if you have ad agencies attached to you. And if there are no ad agencies, then you can just leave the bracket blank. Here you can also change the currency in USD or INR. So this is the way. Then you can add the proposal line item, save or cancel it if you don't want it. Here we will cancel this. So this is how this programmatic guaranteed deals work. Then we will come to the proposal line items. So these are the archived finalized proposal line items. So you can see these have been, there are certain where the review has been requested. So all these are the past deals which have been done, and I have already told you the features of the deals finalized. The setting is same like a direct campaign. Ad type is display standard. This is programmatic deal, and then if it is running on interstitial location, the interstitial location is mentioned. Type is preferred deal, and it is a non-guaranteed campaign. So this will run when the ad inventory is available on a lower priority. I guess on standard priority, the ad inventory is available for running campaign, and there are no roadblock campaigns running, or there are no programmatic guaranteed deals running, then the preferred deals run. So this is the start time, end time, the estimated quantity, the rate, delivery adjust as this delivery also can be adjusted in the day and time. So that is the day and time specification when ads can show for this line item. So you can fix a time when the ads will show. Here you can select the audience, target, demographic, target, affinity, target. So inventory is mentioned, and inventory check and everything is mentioned. So this is how this properties work. Then we will come to the private auctions part. So currently there are no private auctions running. So if you want to create new private auction. So first of all, I would like to say that private auction is something where you invite limited number of buyers for making bids on your premium ad inventories, so that you can get greater yields of ECPM yields on your ad inventory, which you are not getting. So what you can do is that you can select the ad inventory, device categories, operating systems and everything. You need to select it and allow the open auction buyer optimization also in this. And after that, if you want to create a branded auction, then we can also select this branded auction, and this can be done. Want to select any ad unit, you can select any ad unit here. This is the way the premium is mine. You have to create separate line items for separate buyers, and these buyers are targeting only one ad inventory, which will be selected over here, and four line items will be made which will bid parallelly for the ad inventory, and whoever bids the highest will get the ad slot to run their ads. So that is basically done for getting a higher yield. Now we will come to the last section, that is the deal settings. So these PG deals you can set for, like, all buyers can make offers to you, no buyers can make offers to you, only buyer that you specify can make offers to you, or all buyers those that you specify can make offers to you. So it is all like it is depending on you that how you want to keep the deals and how limited you want the buyers to contact you or negotiate with you. That is up to you and up to your choice how you are doing it. So this is the way how this programmatic guaranteed deals work and how this is done. So you need to have a DV360 ID if you want to connect with a publisher, and the buyer also needs to have a GAM ID of this publisher, so that they can contact and they can send their negotiation deals for the publishers. Once the negotiation has been complete, then the preferred deals, which are non-guaranteed deals, and the programmatic guaranteed deals can be run as per the choice and the finalization of the deal among the buyer and the seller. So this is the way how this programmatic guaranteed deals, preferred deals and PMP auction deals work. PMP auction deals are basically done for getting a greater ERL, you are like greater yield, but of generally preferred deals or programmatic deals are done more. And this is the way how this works. We will talk about the delivery part and the orders part in the next demo. So as of now, I'll be ending this programmatic guaranteed demo of Google Ad Manager Dashboard. If you have any queries and questions, you can ask in the comment section. And the private marketplace auction presentation has not been done properly, so I'll be doing a separate demo for private marketplace auctions, where you can learn more about private marketplace. But as far as preferred deals and programmatic guaranteed deals are concerned, I think I have made most of the part in the Google Ad Manager clear. So that's it for the day. We'll see you in the next video. Till then, keep learning and keep implementing new things in Google Ad Manager, and have a good day ahead.